2 val versus 4 val, and this is going to be a tough fight because many of them think still 2 valves are better in terms of cost or in terms of performance, but I'm gonna be proving why 4 valve is better than 2 valve in terms of numbers. So let's get started with the video. Consider two cylinders with the same diameter of bore of 60 millimeters. The first cylinder is a 2 valve cylinder where inlet is bigger in size, measuring 33 millimeters in diameter, and the outlet valve is smaller in size, measuring 20 mm in diameter. The second cylinder, which has a 4 valve system where the two inlet valves measures 25 millimeters each in diameter, and also two outlet valves measuring 20 millimeters each in diameter. Now when you see the 2 valve cylinder, there is a smaller gap between the inlet and outlet valve, whereas in the 4 valve cylinders we have larger gap between each inlet and outlet valves. Now to know why 4 valve system is better, first we have to calculate the intake valve area. So when we see from the side view of the 4 valve cylinder system, one valve will be opened and the other valve will be closed in terms of two inlet valves. So when you see the gap between the opened valve to the initial point, that is called the lift of the valve. So consider it as 6 mm. The amount of air that is entering into the cylinder is the cross-sectional area of the valve opened. So the area is equal to circumference into height, which is again is equal to pi into diameter into lift of the inlet valve. Since we have two inlet valves, the result has to be multiplied with 2. So when you multiply the measurement of the inlet valves and the lift, so 2 inlet valves into 25 millimeters in diameter into 6 mm of lift into pi, which results in 300 pi millimeter square. Now area of an inlet valve of 2 valve cylinder systems, we have the same formula to calculate, but since we have only one inlet valve, the formula will reduce into pi dh. When you multiply the diameter of the inlet valve, which is 33 millimeters, and lift of 6 millimeters into pi, it will give a result of 198 millimeter square into pi. So assuming the same valve lift in both of the 4 valve and 2 valve systems. Now when you compare the inlet valve results, the two inlets from the 4 valve system gives an total circumferential area of 300 pi millimeter square, whereas the 2 valve system, which is having only one inlet valve, will give a result of 198 pi millimeter square, which is almost a 50% increase in the intake, which is gonna let 50% of more air into the cylinder for more efficient combustion in the combustion chamber of a cylinder. Now you can increase the valve size and lift to improve the air intake in 2 valve cylinder, but it creates issues of clearance between the inlet and outlet valves. Now once we have calculated the inlet valves, let us come to the outlet valve. Now when you consider outlet valves for 4 valve cylinder systems, we use the same formula as we used for the intake valve as well, which is 2 into pi into d into h. So when you calculate it, 2 into pi into the diameter of the outlet valve is 20 millimeters into 6 millimeters of lift, which results in 240 pi millimeter square. So for 2 valve cylinder systems, it is only one outlet valve, hence the formula will reduce into pi into d into h, which is then multiplied with 2 pi into 20 millimeters into 6 millimeters of lift, which will result in 120 pi millimeter square. So when it comes into the exhaust efficiency, it is almost double the efficiency when you consider the 4 valve exhaust system and the 2 valve exhaust systems, because in a 4 valve exhaust systems there are 2 valves dedicated for the outlet valves, whereas in a 2 valve cylinder system there is only one valve dedicated for the outlet valve. Hence the outlet will be more efficient And when you compare the inlet outlet of both the cylinder systems, you can see how efficient the four valve system is compared to the two valve systems. So that's all with this video, guys. If you have any questions, make sure you comment down below.